by faith we see the hand of God. In the light of creation's grand design, in the lives of those who prove his faithfulness, who walk by faith and not by sight.
Good morning and welcome to the Chester ARP Church Devotional Podcast. Hey man, it's Friday. Week coming to an end. We're getting ready for the weekend. We've been reading through the book of Philippians, and Thanksgiving was yesterday. I know you guys had a great time and a great day. But as we get going this morning, we're going to read from Philippians chapter 2, beginning in verse 19. As we wrap up this week, we've read through the end of chapter 1 and the beginning of chapter 2 today. I mean, this week, and today we'll finish it out. Here we go. I hope in the Lord Jesus to send Timothy to you soon, that I may also be cheered when I receive news about you. I have no one else like him who will show genuine concern for your welfare, for everyone looks out for their own interest, not those of Jesus Christ. But you know that Timothy has proved himself, because he has a son with his father. He has served with me in the work of the gospel. I hope, therefore, to send him to you as I see how things go with me. And I am confident in the Lord that I myself will come. But I think it is necessary to send back to you Epaphroditus, my brother, my co-worker, and fellow soldier, who is your messenger, whom you sent to take care of my needs. For he longs for all of you and is distressed because you heard he was ill. Indeed, he was ill and almost died. But God has mercy on him, and not only him, but also on me, to spare me sorrow upon sorrow. Therefore, I am all the more eager to send him, so that when you see him again, you may be glad, and I may have less anxiety. So then, welcome him in the Lord with a great joy, and honor people like him, because he almost died for the work of Christ. He risked his life to make up for the help you yourselves could not give me. Now, this is a great passage in the end of chapter 2. We see Paul's true heart. I'm going to make a couple comments that are really somewhat related and somewhat disjointed as well. First of all, we talk about Timothy. Paul says, I hope in the Lord to send Timothy to you. And then he refers to Timothy like a son, because as a son with his father, he has served me in the work of the gospel. That's what verse 22 says. Paul loves Timothy. He's like Timothy's like his son. It's his spiritual son. And Paul invested in Timothy's life, and Timothy responded, and Timothy grew in faith, and Timothy grew in the service of the Lord. They had this deep bond and deep relationship. Paul had a relationship with Timothy he didn't have with any other servant. Now, he loved Epaphroditus, and we'll talk about that in a moment, but Timothy was different. Timothy was like a spiritual son to him. Paul had the opportunity to help Timothy grow. You know from the book of Timothy that Timothy was born to a Gentile father with a Jewish mother. And he learned the scriptures from his mother and his grandmother. But his father was not a Jew and not a believer. Perhaps he became a believer, but he was not a Jew. He was a Gentile. And so Paul loved Timothy. Timothy came to faith. And if that's the case, then most likely Timothy had this great affection for Paul. And he learned from Paul. And he wanted someone to lead him and direct him and encourage him. And so he just tied in with Paul. And Paul tied in with him. And they served the Lord together. And God did great things through them. And they had a great affection for each one of them, for each of them. The next person we meet is Epaphroditus. Epaphroditus, Paul says, is his brother, his co-worker, his fellow soldier. But he's also the messenger whom the people in Philippi sent to meet the needs of Paul. This church loved Paul. Paul loved this church. This church sent an offering to meet the needs of the Apostle Paul. What that was, we don't know. But we know that they cared enough to send someone, and Epaphroditus cared enough to respond and be the messenger who was sent by the church to Rome to meet the needs of the Apostle Paul, to see how he's doing. And they did, and Paul was very thankful. While he was there, Epaphroditus got sick and almost died. While he was with Paul, he got sick and almost died. He risked his life for the work of Christ, on behalf of the life of the church. And the people of God in Philippi had heard that he was ill, and it's brought great distress to Epaphroditus, because he loved his congregation. He loved those people. Perhaps they were related to him, certainly related to him in the Lord through faith. And he was upset, and he wanted to get back and show that he was better, and he was well, and he was okay, and he didn't want to bring any more distress on him, because Epaphroditus loved the church in Philippi. The church in Philippi loved Epaphroditus. And Paul says, I'm all the more eager to send him to you so that you can find out he's okay, because that'll lessen my anxiety. And God was good to me, Paul says, by sparing Epaphroditus' life so that would spare me sorrow upon sorrow. You see, grief is real. Grief is necessary. Grief is actually good in the proper context and the proper length of time as we lose loved ones. And Paul says that's a natural part of life, and God spared me of that by bringing Epaphroditus back when he was close to death. And Paul says, I want him to be there, and I don't want to have anxiety, because Paul realized he was concerned about the church, and he knew the church wanted to know about Epaphroditus, and Epaphroditus wanted to know them. And Epaphroditus, however, would have stayed with Paul if Paul wanted him to stay. And Paul was anxious for him to get back to the church to reconnect and to build that relationship stronger. You see, that's Paul's heart. Paul loved Epaphroditus. He could have used Epaphroditus as a supporting, but he wanted to send him back, and he was anxious for him to get back over there so that he could encourage the church in Philippi and take this letter with him. Listen, I think this is important for us. I think this is very important because it, again, reminds us of the importance of investing in other people. Man, we live in a world, we live in such a world, we feel like we're too old to invest in people. We feel like we have already done that in our lives, or we just get caught up in our own world, and I do the same, and I'm guilty of it. All the stresses and all the stuff happening in our own lives, that we fail to invest in other people for the advancement of the kingdom of God. Paul here, though, is investing in Timothy and Epaphroditus. The people are investing in Paul and Epaphroditus. Epaphroditus is investing in Paul and the church in Philippi. They're investing their lives in each other, because the currency of the kingdom of God is people. It's people. We love each other. We care for one another. We build each other up. It's a constant reminder in the scriptures of what we are to do. And so let me just challenge you and encourage you. Who can you invest in? Who are you encouraging in the faith? Who are you serving? Who are you building up? Is your mind set toward building up others for the sake of the kingdom of God? And is your life focused in on advancing the kingdom through the lives of other people? I pray that it is. We see that testimony in Paul. May God encourage us as we go from this place. Hey, you guys have a great day. God bless you. I'll see you Monday. Church on Sunday, Monday for the podcast. Take care. God bless you. See you soon. Bye.